Members of the Thabo Mbeki Foundation, leaders of political parties, former CEO of Freedom Park, fellow panelists, colleagues, community, and especially my amazing husband Carlos, my daughter Lulu, and my handsome son Samuel, who gave me the best Mother's Day breakfast this morning. Thank you for welcoming me here. It is an absolute honor and privilege to be invited onto the stage to talk about something which is so fundamentally part of my DNA. I grew up in Johannesburg 45 years ago and was never proud of the color of my skin or of my flag or of my anthem. And I always grew up knowing that something was inherently wrong. My grandmother, who I never knew, she died before I was born, but she was a founding member of the Black Sash. My parents were part of the Progressive Party at the time. And so by the time I got to the University of Cape Town, I was, as all students are, at my most activist. And we used to be secretly delighted that we had an ANC sticker. I had it in my bag, which I'd hide, you know, and be secretly delighted that I was this activist. And it was there that, during that time, Mandela was released in Cape Town. And having that first idea, finally, that I could as well feel free, that I could be proud suddenly of the color of my skin and of my flag. And a few years later, I left South Africa, not for a long time, it was just to travel and try and get some experience in another country. I went to England, and it turned into a 7-year stint. It wasn't meant to be that long, but so it was. But during that time, we saw the incredible launch of a constitution. And that was when we heard the speech by the then Deputy President Thabo Mbeki of "I am an African." And many of us white South Africans in the UK listened to this. And I have still to this day not been, I still can't believe how privileged and blessed and lucky we were as white South Africans to have this freedom speech to say, you are part of us. When Mbeki went on to say, I owe my being to the koi in the sand, and he talks about all the different people within it that are part of Africans. And then he said, I'm formed of the migrants who left Europe to find a home on our native land. Whatever their actions, they remain still part of me. And because of that speech, I could feel I am an African. For the first time, I could feel this freedom. And it was a few years later then Mandela came and he spoke at the embassy steps in Trafalgar Square, looking over all of us freezing cold South Africans, and he said, I love you all so much, I want to put you in my pocket and take you home. And the crowd went mad, and I looked around thinking, this is it, this is time to be back. And I returned home to a society that was still in those early days of living these wonderful rainbow nation ideals. This idea that we are all one, we are all equal, we are all together. And because of this feeling of being welcomed, I mean, I remember writing letters home, even when I was still aware of the shiny and new South Africa. I used to write new in a little starburst, and kept being reminded that our constitution was one of the fairest constitutions in the entire world. Never either taking it for granted how lucky we were that it seemed through the Truth and Reconciliation Commission that we were forgiven. And because of all this feeling, this intense feeling of finally feeling home and being home, I launched 13 years ago Homecoming Revolution, which now is a Pan-African organization, but in those days, a South African organization encouraging South Africans abroad of all colors, of all creeds, to come home. The whole ideal being that you're not a failure if you return home, you're a pioneer, you're a revolutionary, you're a wonderful person, you can actually push our society forward, and all is welcome. And I see my 8-year-old son and my 12-year-old daughter sitting in the audience, and I want to reiterate to our children how lucky we were, how remarkable it is that we transitioned in such a peaceful way where there was open arms saying, you are an African too. So Homecoming Revolution's now been going for 13 years. We We've seen 400,000 skilled South Africans have returned home in the past 5 years. We still need to do more. We are still going through the same questions of the love and hate relationship we love have about being South African. But how vital and important it is that we remember how today, 20 years ago, what a miracle it was. The fact that the Constitution, part of it has, in Mbeki's words, we refuse to accept that our Africanness shall be defined by our race, our colour, our gender, or our historical origins. It is a firm assertion made by ourselves that South Africa belongs to all who live in it, black and white. And it's up to all of us individually to say, what are we doing to ensure that our fellow Africans are part of it? Homecoming Revolution Now, we are working to encourage Nigerians living abroad to come back to Nigeria, about Kenyans living abroad to come back to Kenya. This idea that South Africa is a shining light of fairness and equality for the rest of the continent is incredible. This idea too, that as working in recruitment, which we are now doing, and as a supporter as I am of BEE, without a doubt, there's a funny phrase that still exists in South Africa, and it's called AIC. And it stands for African, Indian, or Coloured when it comes to the employment equity thing. And I want to get rid of that AIC because I'm an African too. There's no such thing as African, Indian, Coloured. Black African, white African, Indian African, Coloured African, we are all Africans. And to reflect on those words within President Thabo Mbeki's I'm an African speech, he talks about the summer thunders being full of trembling and hope. And that's exactly how I feel. This idea that we are trembling, we are in a fragile society. If we don't act and do something that we really all acknowledge and defend our beloved constitution, we could slip so far backwards when you think that 95,000 lives have been lost of those inscribed on the wall. It is all up to us to defend our beloved constitution. I feel incredibly privileged to be a white African on this stage. I encourage my other white African colleagues, friends and community, do not forget. Be incredibly grateful of where we are. I am too. Thank you very much.
Today, it feels good to be an African.